How are you? In the last class, we had completed up to the question, prejudice, stereotype and their comparison. Today we are going to start the lesson from the inequality. In India, there are a lot of inequalities are there. And due to that, the discrimination happens. So what is inequality? Inequality is a relationship which makes a non-equal comparison between two persons or a group of persons. It is the term in which people are not equal on the basis of social, economic and opportunities available to them. In India, generally the inequalities happens due to in India, social inequalities are outcomes of inequalities in income, education, gender, caste and class. Preference of sons over daughters is an outcome of discrimination against girls. This has an impact on girls. Next is child education. Next, her right to take decision regarding her body and life, and eventually has an important on the health and education of her family. Next, Dalits and Adivasis, they are not able to get better jobs because of lack of access to proper education. Last but not the least, the gap between rich and poor. So, Indian government has taken some safeguard to abolish this discrimination. The reasons are, the following safeguards have been provided in the Constitution of India against inequality and discrimination. First, equal rights and opportunities. Second, untouchability has been legally abolished. Third, people has the right to choose their own occupation. Fourth, government jobs are open to all. Next, the fundamental rights are safe for all. Next, these two groups which are abolished, they are generally the Dalits and Mahars. Untouchables, also called Dalits, officially scheduled caste, Harijan, in traditional Indian society, the formal name for any member of a wide range of low-caste Hindu groups and any person outside the caste system are generally called Dalits. Who are called Mahars? Mahars are the caste cluster or a group of many castes living chiefly in Maharashtra and in adjoining states. Traditionally, the Mahar caste came from the lower group of the Hindu caste system, but they have witnessed immense social mobility after Indian independence. And this person, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, the architect of Indian Constitution, has did a great job to abolish the discrimination in due to the lower caste. See the biography of Bhimrao Ambedkar. Bhimrao Ramji Ambedkar, also known as Baba Saheb Ambedkar. He was an Indian jurist, economist, politician and social reformer who inspired the Dalit Buddhist movement and campaigned against social discrimination towards the untouchables. He was born on 14th April 1891 in Ambedkar Nagar, died 6th December 1956 in New Delhi. Full name Bhimrao Ramji Ambedkar. His education, London School of Economics and Political Science. He was doctorate in economics from both Columbia University and the London School of Economics. Next, I'm giving one question. What does Constitution of India say with regard to equality? The Constitution of India say the following with regard to equality. Equality of status and opportunities, and to promote among them all. Means it is important for all people of India to be equal so that there should not be any discrimination among any people. The country becomes casteless. Next, another question I am giving. How can the stereotype that girls are a burden on their parents affect the life of a daughter? The reasons are they are not properly cared for, they are not provided nourishing food, they are get married early, they are not allowed to attend or join schools, they are engaged early in household works. So up to this, and I think this up to this portion the lesson finished. So my request each and everyone again that follow the notes properly and write down the question answers as well as the notes. We are going to revise the chapters whatever I taught previously from the next class. But have a nice day.